Hello all. Today we are going to see about RAND index, which is used for evaluating the clustering techniques. So it's a metric which is used to evaluate the quality of clustering technique. We have seen so many clustering algorithms earlier. A clustering is nothing but an unsupervised machine learning technique which is used to group the similar type of data in a single cluster. So RAND index is a metric which tells us how well a cluster is built. That means when given a cluster, when a cluster is built, so how many data points are actually similar to each other. So that's what RAND index is going to tell us. In other words, RAND index measures the percentage of decisions that are correct. So now here we need to understand what is actually a decision. So here RAND index views the process of clustering as a pair of data points compared with each other. That means when we build a cluster, we take two data points, we measure their similarity using some similarity metric. We have seen Manhattan distance metric. If they are similar, we just put them into a cluster. So this is what a decision means here. So RAND index actually measures how many decisions we have made correctly. So that's what RAND index is about. Let's say we have n data points with us and the total number of decisions, that means comparisons. Comparisons is given by n into n minus 1 by 2. So why this? Because like these many comparisons we make with the data points and take a decision and put them into the cluster. So which denotes the pair of data points involved in the decisions. That's what this n into n minus 1 by 2 denotes. Actually, RAND index is given by this formula, which is given by true positive plus true negative divided by true positive plus false negative plus true negative. So we'll understand what are these terms actually mean. A true positive means a relevant data is retrieved. So that means, so let's say we have a cluster which mostly consists of sports category documents. Let's say our data is documents. We have sports category documents and when we have a document which is supposed to get into this cluster, and when the document is also a sports category document, so we have successfully pulled that document into the sports category cluster. So that means we have pulled in a relevant data into the sports cluster. So that's what a true positive. So assigning a relevant data into the correct cluster. So that's what true positive means. True negative means irrelevant data is omitted. So that means when we have a sports category cluster and when a data point, that is, let's say a document which is a political category document, when it is compared with the data points present in the sports category cluster, and due to the similarity between the data points, when it is omitted, that is, when it is prevented from getting into the sports cluster, so that's what a true negative means. We are omitting the irrelevant data. A sports document is an irrelevant data when we have a sports cluster. False positive and false negative are the errors we actually make. So what is false positive means? Irrelevant data is retrieved. So that means when we have a sports cluster and when we actually pull in the, unlike true negative, actually when we pull in the political category document, somehow it got into the sports category cluster. So what we have done is that we have retrieved the irrelevant data. So that's what a false positive. A political category document present in the sports category cluster is an irrelevant data. So that's what a false positive means. So, what is false negative? A relevant data is omitted. So, let's say we have a sports category cluster, and when we have a sports document waiting to get into this cluster, and for some reason it was not able to get into this cluster because it was dissimilar with the rest of the data points present. So, for that reason, it got omitted and it did not get into the actual cluster where it is supposed to be. So, what we have done is that a relevant data was actually omitted. That is also an error. So that's what a false negative means. So we are going to work out a RAND index using this example. So this is the example we have with us. So we have three clusters with us, and we have three types of data points with us, and one is represented as X, and the other is represented in the form of a circle, and the third data point is represented in the form of a diamond. So totally we have 17 data points. So each so when we look at these clusters, the first cluster has 6 data points, second cluster 6 data points, and the third cluster has totally 5 data points. So total data points present with us is 17. So now the total number of pair of decisions we make, so how many decisions we actually make, is n into n minus 1 by 2. So these many decisions we take when building the clusters, that means we are comparing these, we are making these many comparisons to build these three clusters. So that comes to be 136, where n is equal to 17. So for now we'll start, our ultimate goal is to find the RAND index. So RAND index is comprised of four components, namely true positive, false positive, true negative, and false negative. So first we'll start off with calculating the positives involved. The total positive pair of decisions we can make is given by the total positive plus false true positive plus false positive. So we'll first calculate that. So the total po true positive plus false positive is given by 6C2 plus 6C2 plus 5C2. So we'll understand this using this example. So when we have this example, so we here in the first cluster we have 6 data points with us. So these data points both represent a true positive data and a false positive data. So how many comparisons we make here to build this first cluster, we make 6 comparisons we make. So that's what this 6C2 indicates. Similarly, for the second cluster also we have 6 data points. And in the third cluster, we have 5 data points. So we make 5 comparisons. That's what this total positive indicates. So this can be actually solved by using this formula. So that is NCK is given by N factorial divided by K factorial into N minus K factorial. So K is always 2 for us. Why? Because we always take 2 data points for comparisons and compare them and assign them into a cluster. So we'll solve this equation using this formula. So working on the equation 2, that is a true positive plus false positive using the formula we had. So we get it to be 40. So the total positives comes to be 40. So now let's go ahead calculating the true positive. So we'll understand true positive like this. So when we look at this example, so we have in the cluster 1, when we look at it, the mostly it is the true positives are X. This is an alien sample. So we actually have 5 true positive comparisons we make to build the cluster 1. So when we look at the cluster 2, so the cluster 2 we have 4 such circles, 4 true positive comparisons we have. So we have 4C2 here. And when we look at the third cluster, so we have 2 types of data points present there. Though mostly diamonds dominate here, but we cannot ignore the X also. Why? Because we have somehow calculated similarity between found that these two X's, this pair of X were similar and they got into this cluster. So we have to consider both X and diamond here. So we did not consider circle and diamond here. Why? Because they did not occur in pair. So we just ignored them. So here this 3C2 represents the diamond comparison, and this 2 represents the X, the 2 comparisons of X we did while building the cluster 3. So that's how the true positive is calculated. We can use the same formula, n factorial by k factorial into n minus k factorial, and we can find the value of this. So true positive comes to be 20, and we already had calculated true positive plus false positive, that was 40. So false positive can be obtained by subtracting 40 minus 20, that is 20. So false positive is 20. So we're now done with two components, that is false positive, true positive, and false positive. So we are yet to find the negatives. So now the total negative pair of decisions is given by the total pair of decisions minus the total positive pair of decisions. So the total pair of decisions is given by 136. This 136 is arrived by n into arrived by finding n into n minus 1 by 2. Remember, our n is 17, 17 data points we had. So that's how this 136 came. And the total positives, that means TP plus FP is 40. We had already found that. So we get the total negatives to be 96. So now we'll go ahead and find the false negative first. So we have now with us the total negative pair of decisions. We'll find the false negative. That is, remember, what is false negative? Omitting the relevant data. So when a cluster is supposed to have a sports category document, but it did not allow a sports category document to enter into it. So we are omitting a relevant data. That's what FN is about. So we'll calculate it. So we'll understand using the figure again. So this is how it is calculated. We have to focus on each of the type of the data point to calculate the false negative. Let's focus on the X's first. So these X's dominated the cluster 1, but somehow they did not paired up with the 3X data points which are scattered in the different cluster. So that's how this 3 into 5 came. Plus, and also this data point did not get paired up with these two data points. So 3 into 5 plus 2 into 1. And this is about the X data point. And this 1 into 4 represents the circle. The circle did not get paired up with these four circles. So that's what this 1 into 4 indicates. Plus, and this 1 into 3 is about this single diamond that did not get paired up with the these three diamonds. So by calculating this, we get 24. So the total false negative is, false negative comes to be 24. And we already had found the total negatives, that was 96, and now we can find true negative. So true negative is true negative comes to be 72. So this is another way of looking at the four components we had found. So the data which is meant to be in the same class, which is actually in the same cluster, that means that is represented by a true positive component. A data which is meant to be in the same class, but it is in a different cluster, which is represented by a false negative component. A data which is meant to be in the different classes, but in the same cluster, which is represented by a false positive component. A data which is meant to be in the different classes, but it is in a different cluster, which is represented by a true negative component. So finally, this is the formula. So we have found all the four components. And we can substitute all the values of the four components we have calculated, and that comes to be 0.68. So remember, Ri always lies in the range 0 and 1. So where 0 indicates when the decision is totally dissimilar, and 1 indicates which is totally a similar data point. So that's what these values indicates. And this is closer to 1. This is fairly acceptable. And this is how RAND index for a clustering algorithm is calculated. Thank you.